Right. The decision by the Nigerian government to import a Madagascar COVID-19 herbal remedy has also elicited reactions from Reverend Canon Ngochindo Cornelius, a Nigerian professor of diabetology who claims to have curative remedy for prevention and treatment of COVID-19. Let's hear him.
We hereby announce a therapeutic breakthrough on COVID-19 using the tropical organics in Nigeria, just as Madagascar has done. We have saved lots of lives in Europe, in Canada, in the US, and many parts of this world through friends using these prescriptions. And so we decided to implement it in this country. We've started to build a factory. We've made enough that they have given us prescriptions, and we are almost through with prescriptions. So we are calling on good-spirited Nigerians to help us make sure that this factory is set up before 2-3 months from now. We've done so many things according to another specifications, and then we have even gone ahead to get a trademark.
We've had a few of our colleagues in Nigeria making claims about they have something that could be used for that. All we advise, and which the academy always advises, that there are procedures, there are processes for authenticating such things. So any individual in Nigeria, we are happy to hear that they're making progress, but they must go through the approved process, you know, of authenticating their claim. The claims cannot be authenticated on the pages of newspaper. Claims are authenticated on base of research and activities that are done in procedures that are there. So they are well laid out procedures, and that's what the academy stands for, to ensure for the safety of the people that these activities have followed the due process and therefore can be authenticated scientifically. Again, my final talk would be to say that as individuals, we have an important role to play in ensuring that this virus does not spread.
What NAFDAC is doing is trying to bring the practitioner and the herbalist, or the practitioner or herbalist and the researcher together to build a level of trust between the two of them, which was one of the gaps, and that is part of what we are trying to do now. We're going to have a meeting within the next 2 weeks where we will identify some products that are already in our database, NAFDAC's database, that needs clinical trials.